Now we will see the replacing of the wire rope. For that we have to first unscrew that rope suspension, and then we will remove the rope from the drum. Now we will start the unwinding of the rope. We have to fully unwind the rope, then we'll take out the anchoring of the rope, and then the whole rope will be taken out. Now he is removing this rope guides. We will see the replacing of the wire rope. For that we have to first unscrew that rope suspension, and then we will remove the rope from the drum. Now we will start the unwinding of the rope. We have to fully unwind the rope, then we'll take out the anchoring of the rope, and then the whole rope will be taken out. Now he is removing this rope guides. This is the rope guide joining bracket. This is another rope guide joining bracket. We have unscrewed this rope guide joining bracket, and we have removed the rope guide part, that is the guiding part of the rope guide. Now we can see this is the tension spring. This tension spring when it is mounted on the rope, and in that case that will not allow to loose the rope. The function of this tension spring, the spring will not allow to loose the rope. Now he is removing this tension spring. This is the rope clamp on which the rope is anchored. These are the two rope clamps. We are removing these rope clamps. And after removing this rope clamp, our total rope is came out. And this is how we have removed the rope. Now, when we replace, we check the rope. Then we'll cut the rope as per the requirement of the hoist at the lift of the hoist. And then again, we will insert the rope as the procedure is a reverse procedure. Now, we'll anchor the rope end first with the rope clamp. Then we wound it. Then we feed the spring on that. Then we will feed the rope guide. Now, this is the rope. We have removed the rope. Now, how we want to feed the rope again? That is the procedure. That is one end of the rope we are anchoring on the drum. With the help of that is called a rope clamp. There are two rope clamps in this model. That is a 2-ton model. This is the rope clamp. We have to see the particular position that one side it will be the rope, and another side this is the supporting, that a level for leveling this rod is given. So while fitting, we have to take care that is properly fitted. We have to remember that this allen bolt that we are fitting the rope clamp, that should be tightened fully. It is very important to tighten it fully because it is the anchoring of the rope. Now we'll rewound the rope for up to some portion, and then we'll fit the rope guide ring, spring and rope guide ring. While inserting the rope, we have to see that we are giving pressure and we are pulling the rope so that there will not be slackness in the rope and it is fully tightened on the drum. Now we are fitting this tension spring on the rope. This is very important to fit the how it is to be fitted, that one can see. We will see that this rope we have wound up to here. After wounding this rope, we firmly held this rope with the foot of the mechanic, and this spring is kept on this second groove. This is kept on the second groove from both sides. This is put on the second groove, and we will anchoring this total rope guide. This is spring with the help of the tool. This is how we have assembled this spring. This is one lap of the rope. On this lap, we have put the spring and we have anchored it with the tool. Now, this we will fit this rogai ring. You can see that this rogai ring also put such a way that guru is first half part of the ring, that is placed on the roof, this groove of this rope guide. And this is the second half of the rope guide, and this is the portion, it is the portion for the rope that is coming out. That is the cut portion is in the front side, and that complete portion is half of the complete portion will be the back side. Now we'll put rope guide joining bracket. This is the rope guide joining bracket front side. This is the rope guide joining bracket from downside. We have fitted this rope guide ring, the joining bracket. This is the guiding the path of the rope guide, and also that will act as a limit switch actuator. This is limit switch actuator, as well as that will guide the rope guide to the other end for traveling. We have to see the proper position of the bracket such that your limit switch will be actuated properly. Also, that is that fork is the rod is between the fork of the bracket. That this is the rope guide bracket and this is the hoist rod that will guide the rope guide, and that will not allow to move further the rope guide. That rope guide will not be rotated from the other side, and that will be guided properly to the other end. This is how we have anchored the rope, we have put the tension spring, we have put the rope guides, we have put the rope guide joining bracket and the limit switch actuator and guide to the rope guide. That will insert the rope through the pulley of the lower block. Then this end of the wire rope, that is, we fix the rope suspension. This is called the rope suspension. He is anchoring the rope suspension to the anchor of the hoist, and after that he will this U clamp are fitted, that further rope slippage chances will not be there. So these two U clamp fitted is the must, and this should be tightened fully. This is how this complete rope insertion part is over, and now we are fitting these bolts, that anchoring bolt that is also fixed very firmly, and lock nut is also to be provided for that. This is how we are replacing this when the rope is damaged or rope guide is damaged. In that case, we will replace the rope as well as rope guide. This is the method for the replacing the rope guide and rope. It's all.